The tally of the first week of worldwide Switch sales has been released, and things are looking pretty good. According to a report from SuperData, 1.5 million Nintendo Switches have been sold around the world. SuperData's information comes from Famitsu and German-based Global Market Research Institute, GFK. The specific breakdown has sales reaching 500,000 in the United States, which is based on SuperData's own estimate. In Japan, Nintendo has sold 360,000 Switch consoles. That number, of course, comes from Famitsu, which we talked about in a previous video. Outside of those two regions, the data gets a little less specific. European sales are said to closely trail those in Japan, according to a mix of SuperData's research and GFK data. All of these sales figures come from the console's launch week at retail, making them a few days old by now. But overall, they corroborate with what Nintendo has hinted about the Switch's sales thus far. So far, as we've mentioned, things are looking very good, but again, it's important to keep things in perspective. Console launches in the past, such as the Wii U, the Vita, the Dreamcast, these all had very good starts right out the gate. But very quickly, interest petered out. Things do look good, no question about that, but it's up to Nintendo to keep the hype train going and keep people not only engaged, but keep interest from the mainstream consumers high as well. And they seem to be doing just that, with everyone who owns a Switch getting to play Splatoon 2 early and for free. Nintendo has announced that in March, Splatoon 2 will host a global test fire event spanning 3 days. 6 sessions have been announced for the 3-day period, available worldwide. 4 different weapons will be accessible to those in the test, including the new Splat Dualies and remixed versions of the Splat Roller and Splat Charger. The first event kicks off Friday, March 24th, from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. CET. Saturday, March 25th, from 4 a.m. to 5 a.m. CET, 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. CET, and 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. CET. Sunday, March 26th, 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. CEST, and 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. CEST. Recently, we also heard about some new Splatoon 2 features, such as a private spectator mode, LAN support, and even more. So, not only is Zelda the perfect launch game, but right after launch, they're giving all Switch owners a chance to play one of the best third-person shooters of all time completely free. So, if you own a Switch, you really don't want to miss this. Mario Kart 8 Deluxe has gotten some new info, including a release date and an entire overview trailer. The game will launch on April 28th and bring with it a whole bunch of new stuff. New characters, including the Splatoon boy and girl, Dry Bones, King Boo, and Bowser Jr., bring the total number of characters to 42, and probably more carts to pick from as well. A new battle mode completely replaces the old one, having 5 different ways to play, including Balloon Battle, Bob-omb Blast, Shine Thief, and more. The lack of a substantial battle mode was a real letdown when the original Mario Kart 8 came out on the Wii U. So, it's nice that Nintendo decided to not just port the game to the Switch with better graphics and frame rate and all that, but also fix some of the problems and make an even better game. More carts, more characters, a very well thought out battle mode, 2 items at a time, it just keeps getting better. It certainly appears Nintendo is keeping its word about keeping the games coming and not having 6-month droughts like what we saw with the Wii U. Now, speaking of issues, Nintendo responded to the surprisingly large amount of issues people are having with their new Switches. The biggest issue, of course, is the fact that the left Joy-Con suddenly just stops working for no apparent reason, which, you know, could be a real problem if you're, say, right in the middle of a battle with Ganon in Zelda. Though Nintendo previously acknowledged the issue through a kind of weird, bizarre message on its support page, Nintendo of America President Reggie Fils-Aimé specifically addressed the problem in a recent interview with Time Magazine. "We are aware of and have seen some of the reports. We're asking consumers a lot of questions. That's why we want to get consumers on our helpline, so we can get as much information to understand the situation as possible. And so we are in a fact-finding mode to really understand the situation and the scenarios. And with that information, we'll look and see what the next steps are." Nintendo is certainly out of its comfort zone with the Switch, so it only makes sense that there would be a lot of issues for them to work out. But let's just hope that they get it done sooner rather than later. Switching gears for a second and happy news, Nintendo has released a 3-part documentary on its YouTube page about the making of The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild. If you have a Switch or a Wii U, you owe it to yourself to play the new Zelda game. While not perfect, it is one heck of a game. The documentary goes surprisingly in-depth about how they planned everything, interviews with some of the big important names that worked on it, you see concept art, the whole thing. So, if you're a fan of Zelda, and if you're watching this video on this channel, chances are you pretty much are, you owe it to yourself to check it out. The whole documentary is about 30 minutes long, and it's the best 30 minutes you're ever going to spend this year. Well, besides playing Zelda, of course. Finally, Sega has come out with some more news on Sonic Mania. For those of you who aren't aware, and frankly, I don't blame you, Sonic Mania is Sega finally understanding what made Sonic any good in the first place and giving fans exactly what they've been asking for. We see a new level, which is actually kind of an old level, but I mean, you know, the game looks great. For those of us who grew up with the originals, this is a really nice blast of nostalgia, and hopefully the game lives up to the hype. As you all know, Sonic games really haven't been any good at all for like a long time. So if this brings back the magic, so to speak, all the better. It's got bright colors, pop art, classic music. It looks like a great game. It looks like they got all the ducks in the row. But you know, sometimes Sega has this way of just ruining stuff. So let's just really hope they get it done. I really want a good Sonic game for kids these days. Can you imagine some kid nowadays wants to go back and play a quote classic Sonic game? He picks up Sonic 2006. You know what I mean? So I really hope Sega comes out with a good classic Sonic game and say, this is why Sonic was good. So let's cross our fingers. Project Sonic 2017 has officially been retitled Sonic Forces, Sega announced at the Sonic the Hedgehog South by Southwest 2017 panel. And it's coming to PS4, Xbox One, Switch, and PC. The name comes from the game's key element of forces, according to Sonic Team studio head Takashi Iizuka. Both the forces of good and the forces of evil will be fighting. On one side, there is Sonic and his friends, and the other side, there's Dr. Eggman and his evil army. Sega also released some gameplay footage on the YouTube channel, and that about does it for the news. Are you excited for Splatoon? You gonna play on that test weekend? Are you excited for Mario Kart 8? If you owned it on the Wii U, are you gonna pick it up again for the Switch? There's enough new stuff there that I think purchasing it again on the Switch might still be okay. But we'll just have to see how things go. Let us know in the comments below, and thank you so much for watching this video on the Comic Lore.